Hi guys, and welcome to OGLDEV. My name is Etay Meiri. Today I want to show you how to start developing using OpenGL on Windows. There is also a similar session on the channel using Ubuntu Linux, so you should watch that if you plan to use Ubuntu. Let's go over the major steps that we need to take. There is some flexibility here, so I will tell you when you can choose between several options. You may already have some of this stuff installed on your system, so feel free to skip ahead using the timecodes. The first step is obviously to make sure that your GPU supports OpenGL. I recommend going with a minimum of version 3.3, which should probably be available in most systems, even if they are not the latest and greatest. This version came out in 2010 and it will allow you to run most of my tutorials, except the tessellation demos that require 4.0. After that, we need to install some software. You will need some development environment. I'm using Visual Studio 2019 Community Edition, which is free, but you can use any other environment that you are comfortable with, such as Visual Studio Code, which is also free. If you plan to use my source code as a reference, which of course I highly recommend, then you will also need Git. I guess many people are already using Git. It is a very important tool for software development. If you're a new programmer and you are not familiar with the Git, I highly recommend that you watch some tutorials about it and start using it for your projects. Next, we need to get a couple of libraries, which are FreeGLUT and GLEW. I will share more details about them in the next slide, and I will go into even more details in my upcoming videos. In this step, you can choose between using the binaries that I provide as part of my Git repo or getting them yourself. In the case of GLEW, there is a binary package of the latest version for Windows that you can download, but with FreeGLUT, you will need to build the sources yourself. Next, you can clone my sources, and I will show you how the solution is structured and how to use it. And the last step will be to create a new Visual Studio solution and project and take care of all the include and link dependencies. So just a bit of background on FreeGLUT and GLEW. These are two open source libraries that we will use in every single application. They have alternatives, of course. For example, you can use GLFW instead of FreeGLUT, and you can use GLAD instead of GLEW. You can find video tutorials on YouTube for both of these options. I have a tutorial on my website on using GLFW, so I will probably make a video about it in the future. Okay, so FreeGLUT is a portable library that creates an OpenGL context for our application. As we shall see, OpenGL maintains a lot of states such as buffers, textures, etc. And all this stuff goes into the context. FreeGLUT also provides a high-level API for creating a window, so you can use the same API regardless of the operating system. It handles all the events that are triggered by the OS, such as keystrokes, mouse movements, changes in Windows location and size. And it even provides some basic functionality for font rendering and menus. GLEW is the OpenGL extension wrangler library, which means that it knows how to load all the various extensions that the OpenGL driver supports, and it provides access to OpenGL using regular C functions rather than function pointers. Now, don't worry if you didn't get everything. This was just a short overview, and we will go into much more details in the future videos. Checking the supported OpenGL version is actually very simple. If you are on Windows 10, then you can right-click the Start, go to Device Manager, and then to Display Adapters. Now on this laptop, you can see that I actually have two graphics cards. The one is the integrated Intel UHD Graphics 620. And the NVIDIA GeForce MX150. And if you go to the vendor's website, so for example here, NVIDIA.com, find the product, GeForce MX150, and we can see that the OpenGL support is 4.5. So this is okay. And on Intel, there is a similar website, and this is the 620, and we can see that almost the same. 4.4. And also, I highly recommend that you update the drivers to the latest version. So now let's go ahead and install Visual Studio. Search for Visual Studio 2019. There's the link. And we're downloading Community 2019, the free version. Let's open the installer, click continue. And there's a few options here. Let's select desktop development with C++. You can go ahead with the defaults here and click install. This will take some time, so let's fast forward this. And you can select whether you want to sign in. If you have an account with Microsoft, you can create one, or you can just skip it. Select development setting for Visual C++, select your theme, and start Visual Studio. At this point, Visual Studio is ready for work, but we want to continue to install Git. So now let's install Git, and I highly recommend also installing some GUI for that. I'm using Tortoise Git, which is very good, so let's install both of them. We need to search for Git for Windows. You can find the link below. There's the website, gitscm.com, and let's download the 64-bit version for Windows. And I had to run this one by right-clicking and run as administrator. You can use most of the defaults as is, and I only changed the editor to be Notepad++, which I like using on Windows. Now let's search for Tortoise Git and download and take the 64-bit version. Again, just click on a couple of next and install. Select your language. It should detect the installed Git. Type your name and your email. Okay, so you need to install FreeGLUT yourself if you're not taking the binaries from my repo. It's on freeglut.sourceforge.net. The Windows binaries here are a bit old, so you need to build it yourself. Let's take the latest version, 3.21. Extract it. Go into the extracted directory, shift right click, and go to Open PowerShell window here. For this, you will need CMake installed. I'm not covering it here, but it's very easy to install it. Type CMake space dot, and it will generate a solution for Visual Studio, which we can now open. Here's the solution. Here you can select whether you want to build for debug or release. Because this is for educational purposes, I selected debug. Now you can build a solution. Let's fast forward. And we can find the results in the lib directory, according to whether we build for debug or release here. For debug, it's called freeglutd.lib. And in the bin directory, we can find the corresponding DLL, freeglutd.dll, that we will need for runtime. The next step is to install glue. Again, this is only required if you're not taking the binaries from my repo, which is also hosted on sourceforge.net. Here you can take the binaries for the latest version, so you don't have to build it. Let's extract the downloaded file. And we have the release version for 64-bit, which for some reason is called glue32.lib. And we also have a corresponding DLL with a similar name. As I said, I highly recommend that you get my sources, and you can do that with Git now. Just go to the work directory, right-click and hit on Git clone, which should now be available because you've installed Tortoise Git. Let's type the URL, which is https://etaymeiri/OGLDEV. You can find the link below. It will clone the entire repo. Let's go into the OGLDEV directory and see what we've got there. Here you can see all the tutorials from my website, and for some of them, I also have a video in my YouTube channel. All the Windows-specific stuff is located in the Windows subdirectory. In the OGLDEV VS2019, we have the Visual Studio solution and all the projects. In the lib subdirectory, we have a release and debug version of FreeGLUT and the release version of Glue. And in the DLL subdirectory, we have the corresponding DLLs. Let's go into OGLDEV VS2019 and double-click the solution file. Let's make sure that you can build it on your system. I'm very interested in getting this to work on everybody's system. So if you encounter any problem, please let me know. You can press Ctrl F5 to execute the selected tutorial, which is the first one. As you can see, it just opens a window. Let's right-click Tutorial 8, set it as a startup project, and execute it. This is the scaling tutorial. As you can see, when I recorded this session, I already had projects for the first 8 tutorials. And for each new video that I publish, I will add a project here. Finally, let's see how we can create a Visual Studio solution and project for OpenGL from scratch. Let's open Visual Studio and select Create a New Project. Select an empty project for C++, hit Next, type the project name. Let's change the location and select the parent directory where the new solution directory will be created. In this case, I simply selected Documents. Now click Create. And we can see that the solution directory was created with the Visual Studio solution file and the project directory with the same name with project files inside it. Let's go back to Visual Studio, right-click the project name, then add new item. Let's select the C++ file. I'll change the name to main.cpp. And click on Add. Now we have the new file. Let's include stdio.h so that we can use printf and type the minimal main function. Click on Ctrl B to build and let's add a printf. Ctrl F5 to execute. Okay, this seems to work okay. Let's go back to the solution directory and create 3 folders, include, lib, and DLL. These will include headers, libraries and DLLs that will be used by all of our projects in this solution. Let's go to the OGLDEV directory, go to include and GL, and copy all the FreeGLUT and GLEW headers that are here. Let's paste them in our newly created include directory. And if you didn't clone my source repo, then you can copy the FreeGLUT headers from the include folder in FreeGLUT here under GL, same files. And the same with GLEW. It also has a include folder, GL, and all the GLEW headers here. So either way will work. Let's go back to the OGLDEV sources, go to Windows and Lib, and copy the libraries here. And let's paste them in our solution under Lib. Again, if you want to take them from FreeGLUT, then it has also a Lib folder that you can copy from. And the same with GLEW. Let's also copy the DLLs from OGLDEV Windows DLL into our DLL folder in the solution. Again, you can find them also in the bin directory in FreeGLUT and also in GLEW. Let's go to the GLEW website and go to Usage. Here we can see an example for initializing GLEW. Let's copy the include files and paste them in our source code. Let's remove the GL because we didn't use that in our directory structure. Now let's copy the rest of the code into the main function. Let's build this by clicking on Ctrl B. And as we can expect, the build fails because glue.h cannot be found. So we need to add the include folder to the compile command. Let's right-click the project again. Go to Properties, C++, General, and type the relative path to the include directory under Additional Include Directories. Click OK. Now let's build. So the build passes, but the link fails because it cannot find freeglutd.lib. Back to the project properties. Go to Linker, General, and add the relative path to the lib directory in additional library directories. And also add freeglutd.lib to the additional dependencies. And also glue32.lib. remember to separate the file names using a semicolon. Now the build passes. But when we execute, it fails because it cannot find the DLLs. So we need to add our DLL directory to the execution path. This means appending the relative path of the DLL directory to the path environment variable. And now it runs OK. But we didn't get a chance to see the window, so let's add a getchar call to pause the program. And now it works. We can see the window. Congratulations! You have successfully created a Visual Studio solution for OpenGL from scratch.